Hey guys, my name is Jessie Mew, and welcome to the beta update of Cattails. If you watched our alpha adventures, then you know the drill. We're following the life of a feral cat spending her time in the forest colony, and this little kitty just so happens to be named after my real life cat Penny, and so far she's made lots and lots of friends in her colony, so I'm looking forward to seeing what else we can discover now that we're in the beta version. This opens up tons of new doors for us. So far I've seen that we can maybe upgrade our den, we can get new little rooms to plant herbs in and whatnot. We can actually choose our partner now too, so we'll have to see who Penny has her eye on. And I notice that the entire map is filled out now, so we can do even more exploring in enemy colonies, in the Mountain Cat's domain, in the Mystic Cat domain, and then in the top corners, the highlands that we couldn't even reach before. This is new too, my reputation. It looks like, well, the forest colony really likes us, but it's not too surprising that the mountain cats and the mystic cats are not too impressed with Penny. I guess that means we could possibly meet some of the other cats too? We'll have to see what this is all about. We'll have to take our very first steps out into the beta world and see if anything has changed. Oh, is that you, Coco? Hello, Penny. I just thought I would stop by today and see how everything is going. Are you enjoying your new home out here in the wilderness? It can be a hard life at first, but you'll get used to it if you aren't already. I'm sure you've made plenty of new friends, right? Or maybe even someone you'd consider more than a friend? No need to get all embarrassed. I figured you'd find someone pretty special quickly. Am I right? Listen, I have something very important to show you. It might even help you out. Come with me, Penny. Okay, so our mysterious spiritual mentor is showing us something very interesting over here. Maybe this little flower? Do you know where we are? This is called the Sacred Temple. Yeah, we've done a little bit of exploring around here before. If you haven't been here before in your travels, the temple can be found right in the middle of the wilderness. You see this rose bush? It's a special plant, one of a kind. Cats of all colonies revere it. Since you're not from around here, I don't expect you to know the customs of the wild cats. I'll explain. The flowers that this bush produces are considered by many to be the physical embodiment of pure love. If a cat is romantically interested in another cat, they come here to the temple and pick a red rose from this bush. Then they take the red rose to the one that they love. Oh, that is adorable. The recipient cat has to decide if they're also interested in the giver of the rose. If they are, then the two start dating. It's a very serious thing to give a red rose to another cat. Make sure you know what you're doing if you plan on using one. I've also heard of a rare black rose that can be given to end your relationship with another cat, but hopefully you'll never need to use more than one of those. This bush will produce one new red rose each day. Remember, if you're interested in another cat, come here to the temple and gather a red rose. Then give it to the cat that your heart most desires. If you're lucky, they'll feel the same way and the two of you will start dating. Okay, Coco, that's all I had to show you. You should return to your colony now. I'm sure I'll be seeing you around, Penny. Excellent, so that gives us a little bit of an idea of how we could possibly get to know one of these cats a little bit better. So far, we've been trying to decide between Scout, Lyris, and possibly even Doc. Doc is our very, very friendly healer, and surprisingly, he's hit it off well with Penny. But she and Scout do have quite a bit in common. Wait a second, do we have a new cat down here too? Sarge, is that your name? Hold on a second. All thoughts of love are out the window for the moment because we need to meet this brand new cat. Sarge, good day to you. Who are you? I don't think I know you. I guard the forest colonies, so watch what you're doing or we'll have a problem. Oh my goodness, we have a little guard now, a little sentinel standing right at the exit of our colony. Well, that's good to know that somebody is keeping us safe. Good day to you. It's so nice to see green again. I feel the itch to go exploring, though the grass is still too short to hide me properly from prey and enemies. Alright, so we have a brand new cat inside the forest colony borders. I was not expecting to see new cats to meet of our own colony. I figured maybe we'd be able to find some new cats outside the world, those who are living in the enemy colonies instead. But this is quite neat. We'll have to figure out what a Sarge likes. I feel like he seems like a very stern individual, so maybe he would like some food for him to eat. A little snack to munch on while he's standing guard at the edge of the borders. We'll have to see if we can find him anything outside the world. And Mir, let's talk to you too. We'll see if anything has changed for the forest colony since the big update. Greetings, stay sharp out there and don't wander too far from the borders. The fence of thickets that guards our home was built up over the course of many years. He's actually told us this story quite a few times, so it's nice to know that the forest colony is as strong as ever. Now let's head out to the western lands to see if maybe Scout is out here hunting. There he is, looking for those tasty mice, of course. We have our study prey ability right inside our active skills again. We'll have to take a quick peek to see if there's anything new for us to possibly unlock in the future. But right now I want to see if maybe Penny can catch a little meal of her own. Something to impress Scout. Typically when she comes out here to hunt, she doesn't have too much luck, because it turns out that she gets a little bit nervous with Scout watching her. And that's why we're thinking that she might have her eye on him too. But there's somebody over there. Let's use our study prey ability, get up a little bit closer. Oh, it's a big fat crow. Okay, can we pounce on this guy? Excellent, so she is starting to be able to hunt around him, which is good because that should definitely impress our very, very valiant Scout. Penny and Scout are one of the few cats of the forest colony who truly enjoy to go out and explore, so that's one of the other reasons that they do have quite a bit in common. But then of course there's Lyris down here, the sweet poet who always has something very nice to say to Penny. Good day to you, my rose. Perhaps you come to talk for a bit? That is fine by me. I find it spurs my own creativity to peek into the mind of another. Do you exercise your creative muscle often? Make sure you make use of it or you might lose it. Yeah, Lyris does like the more beautiful things out in the world. I'm sure he would love it if we came to him with a rose. Can you imagine? That's probably just the sort of thing a romantic soul like him is hoping for. But let's go ahead and munch on one of our crows. And then maybe we could actually offer up that little mouse that we have in our inventory. We could hold this and then give it to Scout as a little lunch of his own. Huh? Did you need something? Well, we have a present for you. Hey, thanks. I've always liked these, Penny. Excellent. So he still likes the mice. That's good to know. We'll go ahead and grab up these ladybugs too if we can. Oh no, that one skittered away. That's okay. We do have plenty of different colored ladybugs inside our den, and we need to find somebody who might like those as a gift. So I guess we should explore the world too, see if there's anything new for us to find. Hello, Brownie. Looks like we have some cats up here already patrolling the borders. Nice to run into you out here. Excellent, and then we have Feather. Oh, let's talk to Feather too if you're not gonna go right off the screen. Well, okay, I don't think Feather's too interested in talking to us. That's okay. We're actually out patrolling anyway, trying to find brand new things for Penny to stick her nose into. Pretty soon, of course, we're going to have to try to invade the enemy territory, to sneak around rather, to scout around the area to see if there's anything special for us to find there. We did already poke our noses into the heart of the Mountain Cat land before, but of course there wasn't much for us to explore at the time, so maybe we should make our way around the riverbend again, go to this battle right at the Tomb Creek and see if we can lend a paw. It looks like we also have icons for the mining areas too, and there might actually be another one very close to the Mystic Cats as well, right by the prairie. So that's another thing we'll have to investigate in the future, but for now let's make our way to the waterside. Last time we played the game, we tried to do a little bit of fishing. Penny actually sharpened her fishing skills, or swimming skills rather, so it would be easier for her to pounce on her prey. Unfortunately, we didn't have too much luck. She is definitely more of a land hunter, as we have found so far. She has caught so many things today. She is having a really, really lucky day, and she must be feeling much more confident now that she was able to catch something right in front of Scout. Not this little frog though, he's practically hopping right off the screen. Yeah, there he goes. I had a feeling he wasn't going to last. But we should be super close to that battle now, so we can try our paws at our very first battle of the beta update. Luckily, I believe we have some Valerian in our inventory too, as Scout has told us we shouldn't leave the borders without taking some Valerian with us. This will increase our speed, so we should be able to zip around our enemies in case we're ever overwhelmed. But we also have a couple of battle skills up our sleeves, like our Summon Ally skill and our Deep Cut skill as well. So let's see how we do. Let's see if we have any more luck today in the beta edition of the game. I think, honestly, we're gonna do pretty well. It looks like we already have most of the cats taken care of. There's just one more up here, Little Spider, and then we should have successfully defended the Tomb Creek. And to the victor go the spoils. Look at all of these Valerian plants. Excellent, we can pick all of these up, and that way we can use them in all of our future battles too. Now we should be free to continue our way down the stream, keep our eyes open for any little fish that might be super close to the edge, and maybe we could even see that special little flower for ourselves? Since we're so close to the center of the forest anyway, we could make our way down to the sacred temple and get a sneaky little peek at that super special red rose. Oh, and there's that island with all of the herbs too. Now that we don't have any ice here, we can't cross it easily. So do you think Penny is strong enough to get across this river? Her swimming skill isn't the best, but we might as well give it a shot. Yeah, look at her go. Excellent. Just enough to get over to all of these golden seals, the catnip too. We can bring that back for Mare because we know he loves those. And then let's try to catch this fish. Since we're having a lucky day, there we go. We even managed to catch our very first trout. A river fish with white speckles on its back. So maybe we should see if Sarge would like some fish. I wonder if he enjoys the fish any more than like the birds or the mice, and oh my goodness, that was a little bit trickier. We were really fighting a tough current to get over to the other side. But that should put us on the right track to getting to the sacred temple. So let's continue our way over there before it gets too late. We could actually use our own warping ability to return home ourselves, so we shouldn't have to worry about not being able to sleep tonight. But here's the sacred temple. This place is locked, so we can't actually take it over for ourselves. But there's a good reason why, because this is where that lovely little rose bush blooms. It's almost as if this is a little bit of neutral ground. Maybe on certain days, the colonies like to come here to gather and talk together, to meet each other. But I mean, should we pick our first red rose? I don't think we have anybody special to give it to just yet. I think we still need to get to know these cats a little bit better first. But Penny can keep it tucked away in her back pocket as a little reminder. So I think I'm going to do the same thing that I did with our Stardew Valley series. And I'll set up a little poll that you guys can take. It should pop up on the right corner of the screen, so you guys can let me know who you think Penny would be most suited to take on as her partner. I am quite curious of this tiny little paw print here too. It doesn't look like we can do anything, but I wonder if maybe Coco left this behind? There's another one over here too. Very, very mysterious. But I think we're going to use our return home skill to go right back to our den, so Penny can sleep for a little while at least before the sun starts to rise. It's already getting a little bit brighter outside too, so why don't you curl up for bed, go to sleep for your very first time in the beta edition of the game, and then we'll have to eat some breakfast because it looks like she's getting pretty hungry. Luckily, we have plenty of food inside our den. I don't think we're going to be going hungry anytime soon, especially after the wildly successful day that she had before. So go ahead and eat one of your crows, and then let's see if we can maybe impress some Sarge with one of our gifts. We do have that brand new trout, so we could try to give him that first. But if he's not into that, then we have lots of bugs in here to give him. We have that special little turtle shell too. We still haven't found anybody who's too impressed with that one, so maybe it would be Sarge, who knows. Oh, and Coco's back. Hello, Penny, how have you been? I heard a rumor that Ember is now selling shiny trinkets. They're special golden baubles that are extremely rare out here in the wild. Have you found a use for the red rose bush at the sacred temple yet? If so, you'll want to pick up a shiny trinket when you can afford one. You see, shiny trinkets are used for when a cat wants to propose a marriage. Giving one to another cat means you want to spend the rest of your life with them. If a shiny trinket is accepted by a cat, a wedding ceremony will be held the same day at the sacred temple. It's a beautiful symbol of affection, but you should think long and hard before you try to give a shiny trinket to anyone. They're very expensive. You'll also want to make sure that your shiny trinket will be well received when you give it. Have patience and wait for the right time. That's all I had to tell you. I'll see you later, Penny. Excellent. So we haven't even used our red rose just yet, and he's already letting us know about the next step in our journey. But still, that's good to know. That's good to keep in the back of our minds. So let's go to Ember and see what else he has at his shop. If he's selling shiny trinkets now, then he might have something else for us to buy too. Even more for us to spend our hard-earned muse on. So he has all of that food, of course, the golden seals and the marigolds, and there's our shiny trinket. It actually looks like a little wedding ring. That's adorable. A dazzling trinket of human make. Give this item to another cat to propose in marriage. And it's 300 muse too, so that's nothing to scoff at. Then the black rose, an ugly dead flower. Give this item to another cat to end your relationship with them. Oh, that's so sad. Give them a dead black rose to show them that you're not quite as interested as you thought you were. Then we have those inventory expansions, which are always super helpful, and all of the different colors that we can give to our cats too. So I guess we'll have to make sure that we're saving up our muse for this potential shiny trinket in the future. But of course, first things first, we are going to have to get to know these cats a little bit better too. Let's try to give Sarge the trout though. And I just realized it's actually 9 p.m. Oh, Penny slept through the entire day. I thought the sun was actually rising, but because she went to sleep so late, I guess she is not going to be doing too much exploring in the morning hours. Good day to you. Do you happen to like trout, Sarge? Oh my goodness. Wow, you're going out of your way to irritate me, aren't you? I hate these. Oh my goodness, Sarge, I'm so sorry. Our very first catch in the river, and we have deeply offended this cat who is protecting our borders, so we might want to try to amend that. We might want to try to get on his good side instead. And in fact, why don't we see if we can find his den? Does he live right here? I think this one is new. Yes, Sarge's den. The inside is neat, orderly, and simple. Okay, that doesn't give us much of an idea of what he might actually like as gifts. So I guess we're going to have to go in blind on this one. He's already marching off to his den, though. Oh, he's so upset. I'm so sorry, Sarge. I'll try my best to find something better next time. I guess he doesn't like getting his feet wet. He seems like a very, very sophisticated cat, so he probably doesn't enjoy going swimming. And needless to say, a trout would remind him only of the water. It seems like mice are a pretty safe gift to give to any cat. So far, Scout has loved them. Mare has loved them. We could also try giving him some catnip too, though that might not be the best thing for one of our guards to be using. Hopefully he'll stash it away inside his den for later. It would certainly be a good way for him to unwind after a very, very hard day's work, so yeah, I think we're going to try the catnip next. Mare's going to be a little bit jealous that we're sharing his stash of catnip, but I'm sure he'll understand. I wonder when Sarge actually made it to the forest colony. He's very new, but he also seems to be quite well respected just because of all of the work that he's doing to keep us safe. That's why I think that if he got to know Penny a little bit more, he would really enjoy her company because they both have a similar mindset. They just want to make sure that their home is well protected and everybody inside it too. So with that in mind, let's do our best to defend the borders today too. I think one of the battles should be very close by, right along the beach side again, so something tells me this is probably those pesky cats. They have always been the biggest contenders in this forest compared to our own colony too. They're always trying to take over our land, from the fairy wood to the beach, so we'll see if we have a little bit of extra luck. Oh my goodness! Furball is going after that crazy crow, and now their eyes are locked on us. Furball is so quick! Look how fast this guy is running! Well, I don't want to use our deep cut skill because it's only one cat, but thankfully it doesn't look like we're going to have to. Well, that was one of the Mystic Cats, right? And that kind of proves my point. Like, those Mystic Cats have really trained well to make sure that they will be tough contenders for our own forest colony to handle. Let's go ahead and maybe munch on one more of our little mice, though. We'll eat this up so we're nice and full. We'll go ahead and use one of our golden seals, too, to take off some of those wounds that Furball inflicted. And then we should be able to scoot right up to the north to try out our next battle. Right next to the raspberries as well, so we can go ahead and grab those as a sweet treat when we're done. And honestly, it doesn't look like this one's going to be too hard. Only three cats. Three cats this time. That's actually a little bit worrying because typically the Mystic Cats send us many, many more reinforcements. So I wonder if that means that they're planning something big in the future. Well, let's go ahead and try to replenish our stores. Since we did just eat that mouse, we'll bring back another one to give to Scout. Then I think in the next episode, we might have to go investigate the Mystic Colony for ourselves. Maybe we'll sneak back into their territory, all of their swamplands and their marshlands. Now that we know how to swim a little bit better, it should be easier for us. Previously, we had the ice to walk on instead, so we didn't even have to worry about getting our paws wet, but now that it's springtime, I would imagine the swamps will be a bit harder to navigate. Oh, and there's another fish over there too, right in that pond, so it might be a bit easier for us to catch. If we sneak up on it and hopefully it doesn't go too far away, we might be able to pounce. Oh no, you scared away the second trout. Oh, Penny, she must be off of her game though. Sarge's reaction to the trout must have really startled her, and now she's not so sure if she wants to bring back more for her colony. But let's see if we can at least smooth things over a little bit. If we can find Sarge, he's probably on the other side of the colony over here, right by the other exit. So we'll go ahead and grab our catnip. We'll hold this in our mouths and see if maybe this would make him happier. We'll give him the catnip. There we go. We get a little music note from that one. You got this for me? I'm speechless. You're amazing, Penny. So at least we can end it on a bit of a better note than the trout that we gave him before. He is much happier with his catnip, and it sounds like we're going to have plenty of things to discover as we keep exploring the rest of the world. So in the next episode, we'll sneak our way into the Mystic Cat territory to see exactly what they're planning. But for now, thank you all so much for watching, and I'll see you all next time. Bye, guys!